Hello, welcome back again to NX tutorial. So in this video I would like to explain about hexahedral meshing. Now in here we have two types of solid element. We have C tetra contain four nodes, and you can see the shape is like a pyramid. Meanwhile we have also a C hexa in here. This is a first degree element and this is second degree element. The difference is the first degree we have just only node on the edges, meanwhile in here on the mid of the edges itself. So in here I have an illustration how tetrahedral create a solid model by combining, for example like this one. So in here as you can see, after combine it will create like a cantilever beam. And also in here I have an illustration about how hexahedral create solid element. So which one you gonna use, tetrahedral or hexahedral? In here I have a good example, good illustration. As you can see in here I have a geometry. For example, mesh composed by 186 tetrahedral. Meanwhile, when I use hexahedral, I just get 84. It means that the numbers are quite a smaller, almost a half. I think more than a half. And by doing this, you will get more accurate result and also a faster in running the simulation. So this is the comparison between tetrahedral and hexahedral. As you can see in here, the stiffness, hexahedral better, accuracy also, boundary layers for Navier Stokes. This is when you want to create a CFD simulation, and also for a composite, hexahedral better to make an alignment between layers. So a tetrahedral meshing is easy. We just only one click and then we get the tetrahedral meshing. But sometimes we need to create hexahedral meshing. This is to increase the accuracy. Even though it's difficult, sometimes we have to do hexahedral meshing. So how to start hexahedral meshing? First, you go to CAD environment to perform the split body operation, and then you use this one, datum plane, and also split a body tool. Now in here, after you go to CAE environment, you also have a split a body tool, but the difference is in here, check for sweepable body. Meanwhile in the CAD model you will not get this tool. So what is tool for? Split body tool is not just only be used to splitting the tool for a solid CAD model, but also can use to check whether the geometry able to perform sweep mesh or hexahedral meshing or not. So this is when I check the sweepable body, it highlighted in red. So it means that it cannot be meshed using hexahedral. Some modification we must do in order to get a good CAD model so we can do hexahedral meshing. Now after make some modification by splitting the body, I will get two highlights. The first is yellow and the second is green. The yellow, it means that need to make some kind of minor modification. And also I get a green highlight, it means that we are ready to go for hexahedral meshing. And how to do hexahedral meshing? First you create 2D mesh to make the surface mapping of the mesh, and the second using 3D swap mesh and use this option until a target. So you select the source, the source is created using this one 2D mesh, and the select a target is the other surface that not yet being meshed. And please remember, use mesh mating tool. So mesh mating tool will join between the bodies and also the mesh. Okay, by doing so you will get integrated 3D hexahedral even though the meshing came from different bodies. And this is the result. As you can see, even though the geometry is complex, but we can do hexahedral meshing with some steps. Okay, the next video we will show you how to create hexahedral meshing.